Happy New Year, Libra! Welcome to Josie K Tarot. I'm Josie K, and this is the first reading for 2022. For your reading, Libra, I've been guided to the Wisdom of the Oracle deck, and I'm going to be laying a circle spread. But before I do, I'm going to switch the camera from pointing towards me over here to my tripod so you can see the cards as I lay them out in the reading before me. In just one moment. All right, Libra, so here we are again. This is the Wisdom of the Oracle deck by Colette Baron Reed, and I'm going to be laying a circle spread. So, dear Lord, Spirit, Guides, and Angels, please bless whichever Libra or group of Libras I may be reading for during this general reading. Sun, Moon, or Rising, male or female, Venus, Saturn, Pluto, Jupiter, and so on. Please bless this Libra with clearly defined messages regarding the energy that will be surrounding them at the very beginning and into January of 2022. All right. Wow. So Libra, male or female, this is the energy of remaining poised. Okay. This is about how am I going to celebrate my foundation? What is it I want to learn about or do? 2022 is about creating some form of success. What is your soul's purpose? What is it that you always wanted to do as a child? For now is the time to research something, to learn something, to remain poised, even though I'm feeling with this card that this Libra is all over the place, okay? So the spiritual advice at the beginning of 2022 is to just remain poised. And we're going to build on these messages in a little bit. Now, in the thoughts position, we have, so this is why. We have a Libra here in their thoughts, in the thoughts position of the circle spread, who is dealing with some form of chaos and conflict. If it's not around you, Libra, it is within you, okay? And Spirit's saying, just remain poised. Do something that will occupy your mind, pardon me, or the minds of those around you, right? Free your mind from chaos and conflict and remain poised because when it comes to the relationship sector of the circle spread, you have the regeneration energy. So this is in relation to another or others. I am going through a rebirth. I am going through the burning down of the life I used to have, and I am rising above that into a higher, better path when it comes to my foundation and what success means to me in relation to another or others. I need to free myself from this chaos and conflict and allow for that to burn away. I need to research what it is that fulfills me in relation to others, maybe even to like-minded people, so that I can clear my mind of this chaotic energy. Now, in the creative aspects position, thank goodness, if you are praying to Spirit, this is a message that Spirit is listening. That whatever it is you want to manifest, as you pray about it to Spirit, Spirit is telling you that divine timing is at work. So there's a Libra here who's going through a spiritual transformation or who by which Spirit is helping through a spiritual transformation to kind of release themselves from negative worries and fears and to trust that whatever you are creating now, who you were meant to be here on this earth, who you were meant to be remembered for, Spirit's trying to guide you into a better direction in a divinely timed way. So continue to create something in a poised manner and allow yourself as you ground yourself through a hobby, gift, talent, skill, idea, marketing a product, and so on. This whole rebirth will be a lot easier if you ground yourself and trust in Spirit, right? So prayer is a big message here. Now in the actions position, we have co-create. So here you are, Libra, with the owl spirit energy, taking all your wisdom and knowledge and looking at this leopard here. Should I or should I not co-create with this leopard, or will this leopard completely devour me? So there's someone here who's worried about co-creating, creating some form of action with another, and it is causing inner conflict. Divine timing, again, is Spirit's way of saying, let the past burn away, let what was conflicting you burn away so that the new can come, right? Because this is kind of darkening your aura. Write down what it is that is causing inner conflict, and say, I forgive me, I forgive them, I forgive the world, for we know not what we do, and then burn that in, you know, a flame and let it go. It's time to co-create with new people, to find this energy of peace and harmony once again. And that's a big message to the collective in the year of 2022. So look at this, Libra. Emotionally, whatever you put your time and effort into, again, Spirit is watching and they are helping you to co-create with like-minded people, whereby you can eventually bring something new to life, right? So there's this transformation in relation to another or others, and the realization that as you connect with people who do what you want to do, right? We learn from each other and then we teach the others. There is the ability to manifest a new life. And as you do, the old life of chaos and conflict is falling away. So in the subconscious position, Spirit's saying, take some time to think things through. We've got my favorite number 44 there. Am I in a solid foundation of peace, joy, and happiness? Am I doing what it is that I love? Have I found something to research that really grounds me day to day that I know is my soul's purpose? I can take what I've learned, no matter how difficult it was, and I can create an opportunity to share how I surpass these difficulties with others. Because if you take some of the most painful experiences in your life and you use them creatively or to educate those who are now going through what you went through long ago, you could write a book, you could bring something to life where you can help others, right? And I do feel like healing businesses and assisting and lifting each other up is where the success is going to be found. The joy and happiness is going to be found in 2022. So in the day-to-day aspects position, we have this milk and honey card. Spirit saying, remember, we are divinely timing things out so you can ebb and flow in your life, so that you can bring something new to life that fulfills you emotionally, and you can free your mind of the chaos and conflict. So think about and trust that Spirit's bringing you through a rebirth in relation to another or others, or even within yourself and your inner child, and is helping you to take action in a poised manner to co-create with others and manifest this milk and honey energy, abundance and joy, a brand new life. So in the inner strengths position, we've got between worlds, right? So Spirit's giving you the strength to sit between the world that no longer fulfills you and move into the path of what and where Spirit is trying to guide you. So Spirit's saying, we're divinely timing things out for you as we give you the strength to sit in between where you're at and where you will be, to contemplate what action steps you want to take to come together and build a new life, a new project, a new chapter for yourself in your life path journey. So in a three-card summary over here to my left, we have flexible, unfinished symphonies, and finally, we have the happy, happy card. So in the first position, representing the first week or two of 2022, Spirit saying to this Libra, continue to plant seeds, goals, and intentions, and remain flexible. Trust in prayer and know that things need to be done by the book, right? Things need to be created and planted, and then we need to wait and tend to them until they start to grow and prosper. So yes, indeed, you may be feeling like you are standing at this fork in the road, right, between worlds, but Spirit's giving you the strength to do so, telling you you're going to be moving into a better direction here, and that in this moment, right, you are to be mending, realizing that what has burnt away in order for you to evolve spiritually. So you may feel like your heart is a little bit empty here, but Spirit's saying pay attention to the signs and synchronicities. Give thanks to Spirit for the beautiful foundation you have manifested for yourself up to this point. Yeah, we have someone really questioning why this happened, why that happened, and that's why Spirit's saying, Someday you will know, someday you will understand, someday you will even be able to explain. And as you do, you recognize that a new life, a new beginning is happening in your life as a result of this intensity. So some of you, by the second or third week of January, you may be feeling this unfinished symphony energies, feeling like something was left unsaid, but Spirit's saying, in the meantime, go the distance, right? Don't give up. New doorways are opening. So come to the edge and look at where Spirit's trying to guide you when it comes to your own personal success, because where they're really trying to guide you is into the energy of peace, right? So your mind can be cleared of the chaos and the conflict. So sit and observe and exchange communications, for eventually you will connect with your tribe. Truth be told, you sat in the here and now and you waited for a doorway to open, and then there came a change in the wind where you started to manifest a solid foundation. You started to feel like ebbing and flowing with the milk and honey energies. I have surpassed obstacles and challenges and now am recognizing a direction of success. So by the end of January, going into February of 2022, we have some form of message in a bottle coming. And I think in that bottle lies a key to your goals and intentions that is in turn going to bring you energies of happiness. The realization of who you want to take action to co-create with, which direction you want to go, and the new life that you are being born into, which is interesting. Yeah. So as you create something that you're passionate about, as you start to be freed from the pain of the past, beautiful new things are coming towards you, like maybe to your home, or changes are coming and you start to realize, wow, I have created a beautiful life for myself and I'm going through a new rebirth into a new life, where I can now focus on energies of success. Yes, someone came before you for but a moment in time, and Spirit saying now it's time to find balance. For there will be a deep knowing that Spirit has given you a leg up here. Wow. So for further clarification and confirmation, I'm going to be bringing in the Gilded Tarot deck. I like to clarify with a tarot deck because it helps for me to confirm and clarify the astrological signs and or elements by which this Libra may be connecting with during the beginning of 2022 into and through January or so. Okay, so we had a card jump. Let's take a look. Okay, so someone's feeling like they're not being offered enough. Do I want this love? Is this the love I want? It's kind of what I'm hearing. Is this offer what I want? Spirit saying, remain poised. If you're indecisive, remain poised. Do some form of meditation to free yourself from this in-between moment of chaos and conflict. Look at, Spirit's really trying to help you out here, Libra, with the major arcana, the Empress energy. So they're saying, think about now what it is you would like to give birth to, okay? Because whatever you give birth to now, you could offer yourself fulfillment. You can free yourself by manifesting something new from energies of chaos and conflict. Now, I do feel like sometimes the Empress energy is a mother figure, grandmother figure, very spiritual feminine. And there's some form of conflict or chaos in your thoughts. Maybe about, can I give birth to something new, or about a mother figure? I'm going to keep going. Now, in the relationship sector of the circle spread, we do have this beautiful Page of Cups energies. So some form of communication is coming, and maybe you don't want it. Maybe you're figuring out how to offer it when it comes to a mother or grandmother figure. Okay. So, you know, Spirit's saying free yourself from the thoughts of chaos and conflict and just continue to give, to manifest kind words and messages in relation to another. Remain poised as you kind of observe this energy. There's a big message here about giving kind words and messages to others, so too will bring them back into your direction, right? As we treat others a certain way, so too will we be treated. So yeah, someone here is really thinking about a soul connection with the Two of Cups energies, about creating a connection that feels right. And Spirit saying, don't worry about it. With the number 30 here, right? The TikTok card is about divine timing. Spirit's got this all under control. It's very difficult to manifest when you're dealing with thoughts of chaos and conflict. And that's why Spirit's saying it's time to give care, provide support, others, or open your heart to the relationship. I think someone's overthinking a relationship. And there's a feeling that, you know, is this right, is this not? But this is a soul connection here, and it is divinely timed, and Spirit's got it going on for you. So just pray to Spirit to take control of this and remain poised, is the advice. Now, in the actions position, we have the Three of Wands energies. So co-creating with another or others in the actions position, recognizing in hindsight, maybe close to, I'm getting like the third or fourth, maybe the 10th, okay, different people, of February. You recognize that your harder work and efforts has now brought your ship in. You're looking at an offer or opportunity and you're kind of like, is this my ship coming in? I feel like this is creatively. So emotionally, look at that. You receive some form of positive attention and recognition with the Six of Wands energies and are realizing emotionally that it is indeed time to manifest greater and better in your life. Even if it's kind words and messages, communicating, letting go of the worries here. So here you are in your element, male or female, Libra. The Queen of Swords energies is about setting goals and meeting goals in a very balanced way, and very kindly, fairly, and justly cutting away from anyone or anything that brings negativity into your energy, right? If you can't get what you want, Spirit's saying, create what you want, and it will be created back to you or for you. So in the day-to-day aspects position, oh my, here you are in your element as well, with the Justice card as a major arcana representing those who have Libra in their chart. So definitely thinking about marriage, commitment, partnership, is this the right one? Spirit's saying, don't worry, remain poised. Everything's going to ebb and flow. Divine timing is at work. Your ship is going to come in. Attention and recognition will come your way as a result of kind words and messages. You maintaining balance and poise here. You will eventually be manifesting a new life, a new chapter, because Spirit is going to eventually bring that ship in towards you. Some form of wisdom and knowledge. So yeah, this is a time to co-create with others. Take one foot and put it in front of the other and remain poised until you recognize exactly that the time is right. So in the inner strengths position, we got the Eight of Cups. This is walking away emotionally from feeling as though someone's not giving you the communication you desire for some Libras. Yep, see, going away from a path that no longer fulfills you. Going away from a path that no longer fulfills you emotionally with the Eight of Cups. Spirit's giving you the strength to do so. To remain poised as you observe the communications with others. Could be mother or grandmother. But trusting that Spirit's helping you in the area of justice and balance. They're going to bring a beautiful ebb and flow energy with that milk and honey energy as you co-create with others in your actions position in January and February. You will eventually recognize that a new life is unfolding for you. So this is a lot about just trusting that Spirit's got your back. They're going to lead you into a new life in a beautiful way. Yes, so you may be a bit indecisive. You may be thinking about money, but Spirit's saying when it comes down to the Hermit energies, marriage, commitment, partnership, the next chapter of your life, you're going to eventually recognize that all that has been went full circle and that Spirit is leading you into and through the portal of a brand new beginning. This is also that it's time to bring something full circle in the area of someone who has Taurus in their chart with the Hierophant as a major arcana. So that you can lay down the weight, a heavy weight on your back, regarding a younger, more maybe difficult child with the Page of Swords energies for some. Yes, knowing that Spirit is going to help you to take all those worries and fears and leave troubled waters behind, because a new portal is opening up for you. And I'm getting this is in the area of money, a lump sum of money, an inheritance, a win, or just a path that's going to grow and prosper. Yep. Having the strength to look at a new path, to receive that attention and recognition, to make eventually a decision. Yep. And come out of confusion regarding the Emperor, which could be someone who has Aries in their chart, or someone around you is setting goals and meeting goals that's in a leadership position who has Pisces in their chart with the moon. The point is truth and victory is going to come. And I feel like it's a water sign that's going to come excitedly towards you, or there's playful energy that's coming towards you, and you start to recognize that you have manifested victory. You or someone else has manifested, look at that, with the Magician. A new direction in the area of money. Maybe you're worried about money. Indecisive about love. You know, I'm going to clarify with the Romance Angel deck for this one. If this is a career in finance, justice is going to turn in your favor. You just have to wait for the right offer to come. Free your mind from inner conflict, outer conflict, and give birth to new opportunities for yourself. For you can co-create through your actions with another or others. And eventually, the third or fourth opportunity or connection is going to be the right one. And then a new life can be born for you. There is a soul connection here that's meant to be. I just feel like there's a Libra here who needs to kind of clear their thoughts. Here we go, right in the center of everything, we have the wedding card, Libra. So remain poised as you contemplate an offer of love. You may want to give birth to a forward movement. Maybe you're the mother energy, or yeah, because for some of you, you're thinking about passion, but there's conflict there. I'm conflicted. Maybe the passion has died out a little bit. You're trying to plan a wedding. For some of you who are having issues in the area of family, spirit saying that your love life could very well benefit as you forgive another or others, right? This is about, I'm going to let the past burn away, and I'm going to offer kind words and messages with the Page of Cups so that I can heal from all that has transpired in relation to another or others. So remain poised, spirit saying, and think things through. Remain balanced and just be kind, okay, in the midst of confusion here at the beginning of 2022. Now, creatively, spirit saying, remain positive about your love life, because this is indeed a soulmate, and divine timing brought you together. Divine timing is still at work here, but it's important that you heal in relation to family or friends and remain optimistic when it comes to creating marriage, commitment, partnership. Yeah, take some time to retreat, to disconnect from the world, to think about what action steps to take to co-create with others. I think financially, because eventually your ship is going to come in. Yeah, see, we have a Libra, go figure, who's trying to control some form of situation here. Because I think maybe marriage is like, I want this marriage, I want to create a new beginning, the next chapter. But Spirit's saying, emotionally, you just need to let things unfold naturally, okay? Remain optimistic, heal in relation to others, and trust that Spirit's going to help for things to unfold in a perfectly divinely timed way. So not in the way you want. Now, you may be thinking in a way where you've got your sword up and you're a bit protective, because you are fearing red flags in the area of marriage, commitment, partnership. And Spirit's saying, you know, that needs to heal. There needs to be optimistic, creating something optimistic where you can create time to retreat. Okay, yeah, maybe the passion is burnt away, but there's no way to control how this is. Spirit's saying, we have been in control the whole time, Libra. If you need to, now is the time to have a heart-to-heart conversation about this happily ever after energy, about marriage, commitment, partnership. Remember to remain optimistic. I feel like Spirit's saying, passion comes through sharing kind words and messages with one another. Really, all you have to do in relationship is retreat, ground yourself, and heal. Okay, it's time for a new beginning, and the past cannot come with. is what I'm hearing. So in the inner strengths position, all you've got to do is trust. Trust that divine timing is leading you from a world that is now gray and dark and no longer serves you, where you can leave an old emotional person, place, circumstance, situation in the past in search of a wish come true, right? Great emotional fulfillment. So trust and have faith in this marriage. Take time maybe for the two of you to retreat, to regain that passion, or just let go and find some time to be alone. See, we have true love smack dab in the center of this reading. So Spirit's saying, free yourself. Take back control of your life. Take back control of your mind. And free yourself from this codependent energy that you are stuck or trapped. Yes, this is a true love. Maybe some are thinking about the past, but no. That's a no. Look at this. As you release thoughts of your ex, what used to be, it is time again to free your mind and clear your energy so that clearly Spirit can help for you to move into. And I'm feeling either this is a new love if you're single, you know, fighting with do I want to get married again type energy, but this is also a renewed love. Getting back together and planning something in a positive way, right? That's how the chemistry and the passion will return, is if you share kind words and messages with one another. They're saying, yes, this is indeed the relationship you've been waiting for. But because of certain difficulties, it's been hard to kind of breathe. So retreat and create something and know that your actions are going to lead you into a beautiful and better direction. You just need to heal and let go of red flags and worries and fears and find contentment by creating something, bringing something new to life in your own personal journey. I'm going to close with one last message from the Guardian Angel deck by Doreen Virtue. Now, if you are single, I'm seeing over on my other deck that you may be planting seeds in the area of love. A new person could for sure be stirring your romantic feelings at the very beginning of 2022. What's behind that? Yeah. It's a time to get clear about where you both stand and what you both desire. And if that person doesn't want something that you want, then you move on to the next if you're single. Nine of Action. So during the beginning or around the beginning of 2022, the card says, you have worked hard, Libra, to create the things that you cherish in your life, such as beloved relationships, amazing accomplishments, and hearth and home. Rest assured that all these treasures and you are being constantly protected by your angels at this time. So a new topic or intellectual project is something that is going to excite you. Figure out what that is or go after that if you know what it is. For there is so much to learn before you will feel ready to move forward. New information may require changes to your plans, right? But review everything carefully. This is the beginning of a new emotional experience that could grow into something so much deeper for you. You may even receive some of you expressions of feelings that you didn't even know were developing. For others of you, a social invitation is on its way to you, and it may be in a new direction where you meet someone new. But it's time to get back into balance. If you've been confused about any situations in your life, know that suddenly everything is going to start to become very clear to you. Whether the truth is revealed by your angels, disclosed by a friend, or discovered on your own, it will feel great to be awake and to be aware. So feel free to ask for time alone if that's what you need. For you have created a lot of success, and now you need to wait for Spirit's timing to catch up. And in the meantime, retreat, meditate, Exercise, eat right, market a product, start a hobby, do something that grounds you day to day. And let spirit guide the way. So should these messages have resonated for you, or you have further questions about your own personal journey, feel free to write me for a personal reading via my email, which is josiek42@gmail.com. I offer 4 1-half-hour video readings, and they are a 1 month, 3 month, 6 month, or yearly reading, and my price list will be in the box below this video. I am now offering the winter special, which is a 15-minute video reading for just $25 if you'd like to give that a try. So thank you so much for your likes, your shares, and your subscribes. Thank you so very, very much to those of you who have continued to donate to my channel to keep it up and running. Take care, and God bless.